And that's gone.
A big deflection there, and it's a good piece of bowling by Garner. And Australia 2 for 26 now, with Border, Port Murray, a good catch, sharp one away to his left-hand side. And Garner has struck to back up Croft's first wicket.
A very good delivery from Garner, and you see it cut quite sharply off the seam. Alan Border perhaps following it rather than trying to get out of the way of it. A very good catch by Derek Murray and a tremendous delivery. We watch the ball, how it pitches and about middle and leg, even leg stump, and cuts right across Border. And in fact, I would think that he really had to play off that. The only thing, he may have perhaps been able to drop his hands, but it's early in his innings and it's hard to do that. Australia 2 for 26 in the 14th over.
And he's peeled against for caught behind. He's out, caught behind. Out for 92. So Bruce Laird goes. Disappointment. Eight short of what would have been a landmark for him. A fine innings ended. Port Murray, Bull Garner. And here's the deserving reception for him as he returns.
Well, it certainly was a fine innings by Bruce Laird. The crowd rising, applauding him off the ground. Tremendous innings for his country. Weathered the storm early on, and this is how he got out. The ball slanting in and then holding up a little bit. Through to Murray. A big appeal from the West Indians, and the umpire giving it careful consideration before deciding that he'd nicked it. See it from the reverse angle now.
So that's the fifth wicket gone for 228.
Saul Garner from the members' end. Deflection. And that's a great catch. What a magnificent catch by Derek Murray. Beautiful bit of wicketkeeping. And a vital wicket for the West Indians. And what a great catch by a captain. First time as captain of the West Indians, taking a beautiful leg-side catch. Moved quickly. It was wide of the off stump. Great anticipation and a beautiful catch.
Magnificent catch. What a great catch by Vivian Richards. Magnificently taken.
There's the dismissal again. And this will have to go into the record book, I think, certainly into our catches of the series. The ball was past Richards when he took it. Incredible. Look at that again. There's the edge. Fallibility of Border outside the off-stump. Now look how Richards has to go back as well as across to take that left-handed opportunity. What a catch.
It's 2 for 55. And just 21 years of age. And he's taken it. Beautiful catch. He's in the action. Michael Marshall scooping up a beautiful catch. Diving forward and snooping on that ball, and he's right in the action there to break the partnership.
Good catch this by the young man, substitute, diving forward but taking that ball into the bit of the turf. Very good catch indeed, and that is the wicket, one of the wickets that they wanted, and it's now 3 for 179.
He works hard at his batting. He bats a lot in the nets. He's tall and likes to get on the front foot, but just to me, it appears to be always at fraction weight. He's out. A magnificent catch by Lawrence Rowe. Mallett hitting square of the wicket, and Rowe throwing himself to his right. Took a magnificent catch, in my word. The West Indians are on fire.
Oh, what a great catch that was. Moving away to his right and snatching that out of the air. And that's the ninth wicket down for Australia. Ashley Mallett playing a shot. Feet together, the ball away from the bat away from his body, the ball in the air, and Lawrence Rowe snuffling that as it went by. And that's the ninth wicket going down for Australia.
And the West Indians have caught all batsmen today. 9 catches for 9 wickets, and Garner's 50th test wicket. And there wouldn't be many better catches than that, as Ashley Mallett departs without scoring. That's 9 for 189.
He's gone out, leg before wicket. Garner strikes Laird, leg before for 36. And 4 for 83, the Australian score.
Well, the position worsens for Australia as the day goes on. That ball coming back off the seam, beating the defensive bat. They go, the appeal of LBW, and Max O'Connell says that's out. Bruce Laird, the fourth wicket to go down. He's made 36. The total is 83 for the loss of 4 wickets.
Garner has picked up another wicket there. Kim Hughes, LBW, for 11. And Australia now 5 for 98. Drinks are coming out.
Hughes, surprised by the ball keeping down a little bit, I think expecting that ball to go a long way down the leg side and miss leg stump. An opinion which umpire O'Connell did not share. He seemed to think that ball was hitting leg stump. As you can see, the angle was pretty pronounced. And Hughes was not too pleased as he left the crease. 5 for 98.
Here's Marsh on 21. And this is the 46th over. It's a nick and he's gone out, caught by Vivian Richards. Well, that was a pretty orthodox catch for Vivian Richards, and he took it so nonchalantly, straight to him, made no mistake. So Rod Marsh on his way back to the pavilion.
It might have been an orthodox catch, Tony, but that certainly swung the game. Just as Marsh and Hughes was looking good, the bounce and the direction of that line and length from Garner was too good for Rodney Marsh, and Vivian Richards did the rest, and that's a vital breakthrough for them. It's 6 for 115.
For 44.
And that's it. The yorker right through him. And an important innings from Bruce Yardley. Not the most effective or orthodox of shots. And this is how it finished.
The perfect ball for the occasion. Yardley had been playing the ball on the up, outside the off stump, just helping it on its way through the slips. Garner, realizing this, puts the yorker in right on off stump. And that's the end of Yardley. Very effective 21. He departs with the total at 7 for 149.
850s and 600s and an average of 34.
Oh, and there's a big appeal. He's given out. He's out, caught behind. Well, that's the breakthrough the West Indians needed and Australia could have done without. An outside edge from Wood there. A good bit of bowling by Joel Garner and well taken by wicketkeeper Murray, who gets a little pat on the head from Backers.
It's always easy in the commentary box, but Mitchie Bonneau mentioned at lunchtime that this angled bat of Graham Wood was going to get him into trouble against a bowler who bowls a right line and length. And for the second time in the match, Wood goes caught behind. That's the perfect line and length. He doesn't play with the full face. You notice he angles it and folds it towards the slips, and Murray does the rest. And just when Australia were set, Joel Garner breaks through, and it's 1 for 82 as Greg Chappell comes on.
Up there to a ball that he nicked down the leg side.
Well bowled, he's bowled him. That's a beautiful yorker. Well, he's been trying for a while to slip one through the guard of Yardley, and that was a magnificent one. Right up in the block hole at pace, and back goes the middle stump.
The West Indians needed that wicket because Yardley was a danger man in this situation, and that was the perfect yorker. Middle stump, and Yardley departs for 12, but he certainly made some contribution towards the score at this stage. That's beautifully bowled. He's reasonably wide, and there goes the middle peg, straight back. And the big gap is found out by Joel Garner, who's bowled very well in this innings. At 7 for 215.
Had enough force to take it to the boundary.
What a good ball. One that comes back from outside off stump. Beautiful piece of bowling that from Garner. And now the Australians deep in trouble. Still need 45 to save the follow-on.
Well, two fine pieces of cricket. First up, Hughes getting Garner away for four and then Garner retaliating. A beautiful ball that came in.
and collected the off stump, and that's a vital breakthrough for the West Indies. Australia still needing 44 runs to avoid the follow-on. Kim Hughes out for 16, and now Australia 6 for 141.
That's it, he's out. Call it second slip. Loy just moving from first slip, just behind Greenidge at second to take the catch. And Dyson goes, waiting for the decision. Let's have a look at it.
Well, it's one of those ones where you jam down. Dyson stood, no doubt about Kai Ward or Joel Garner. And that's what a reward you get for keeping the ball up. And Dyson's out, and it's 2 for 35.
I found, I think from about the age of 25, 26, that I got a bit of benefit from opening up my stance.
What a great catch that is by Backus. That short leg. The West Indies have broken through twice now. Marsh and Hughes, the overnight not out batsmen, have gone. That one to a very sharp catch by Fayed Backus, and West Indies right back in the game. Kim Hughes goes off, out for 84.
Very sharp catch at bat pad. In fact, that one coming straight off the bat. You're not really expecting your close-in man to catch those. Joel Garner, a very pleased man. Kim Hughes can be very proud of himself, the way he's played for his 84. And Australia are 6 for 373.
Well bowled. Joel Garner has done it again. He's got through Yardley's defence. And the West Indies getting right back into this game. The bowler's giving the batsman a chance now.
Tremendous delivery there from Joel Garner. And once again, you get a very good idea of the cut that Joel Garner has got out of the wicket this morning. Tremendous off-cutter from the Big Bird. Rattles Bruce Yardley's leg stump. A very disappointed Bruce Yardley leaves the scene. And Australia in a bit of strife now. 8 for 383.
It's a chance. It's got him. Yes, they're out. All out for 386. Australia lead by 235 runs, so the West Indians need 236 runs for victory.
What Wood will do about it. Lloyd, great catch. Great catch. And well bowled by Garner. He put that man out there at square. Wood wasn't sure if the short one was going to come. Got the one roundabout off stump cutting away. And that was a brilliant catch by Clive Lloyd, who's now taken two to dismiss the two Australians.
Survival's the main aim now for the Australian batsmen. Start again tomorrow. Vessels has been very watchful. Played very well indeed. For his 13 runs. Just hit the half volley and placed that well.
Good shot, but well caught. Beautifully caught in the gully there by Michael Holding. And that was pretty well hit. Kepler Vessels would be considered a bit unlucky. Hit that right off the middle of the bat. But the tall man in the gully, Michael Holding, just dragging that catch in. Michael Holding is actually racing off the ground.
Clive Lloyd has the first one again. Not a very good shot there from Kepler Vessels. He's gone. Joel Garner, despite no ball, no ball, no ball, has snapped up the first wicket.
There's the Yorker, and that could be out. The edge from Wayne Phillips, an attempted Yorker, and quite comfortably taken by Wayne Phillips' opposite number, Geoffrey Dujon. So the first Australian wicket down this morning.
Garner working hard for that wicket. He's been peppering Phillips outside that off stump with balls a little shorter than that one. He enticed Phillips into the drive. He wasn't across there. And what a good game Geoffrey Dujon's having. Garner produces here.
And there it is. Yes, I think that was very predictable. Right on target.
And when you're in the frame of mind of letting the ball go, most of the time, it's a bit difficult to get down on those.
And didn't he set him up? Forced him back, and it was standing out like the proverbial. So, the West Indies picking up 4 wickets this morning in just 25 minutes. And just 1 wicket now standing between a victory in this first test match in Perth.
The vessel's taking strike, and your commentators Ian Chappell and Frank Tyson.
Oh, and he's let it go, and it's hit off stump. And really kept the vessels very conscious of not edging that ball into the slips, has made a bad error of judgment.
Your Garner bowls now to Kim Hughes.
There's the hook, and there's the fielder, and he's out caught. Off the hook shot, Kim Hughes goes for it once more. Malcolm Marshall takes the catch, and Kim Hughes, for the second time in the series, is caught at long leg off the hook. The second Australian batsman today to go to the shot. 4 for 81.
And then he follows it up with a yorker, and a very accurate yorker he has got. He's polished off some tail enders with that yorker in his time.
It's absolutely deadly in its accuracy. It always hits the leg stump.
Joel Garner, the bowler. He's gone! Yes, he's out! First ball! Oh, that's from Dujon. And the runabout for Kim Hughes in Australia continues. A beautiful piece of bowling, but what a superb catch. Everybody hoping for Kim Hughes to succeed. He's failed, and Australia in real trouble at 3 for 91.
Lawson adjusts his chest pad, gets that into position. Garner's added an extra couple of yards onto his run. He slips in the gully in position, and all the West Indian fielders will be aware of the single.
And he's gone! He's out, caught behind, a huge nick there. Lawson standing his ground, but that is a big edge and taken beautifully by Dujon. I mean, to jump high in the air. And so Lawson, after a tremendously courageous innings, getting a standing ovation here, out for 49. It's in the air and he's gone. Beautifully taken there by Harper. Diving away to his right, no mistake at all. He never looked as if he was going to do anything other than catch that. That ball just outside off stump, and what magnificent hands he's got.
Yes, all of the West Indian fieldsmen seem to be pretty adept at catching. This was a good delivery. Boone followed it. It moved off the wicket, and look how far the bat is from Boone's body when he makes contact. He did that in Brisbane as well, falling in similar fashion to an equally brilliant catch by Michael Holding, but that was a beauty. And Roger Harper picking that out of the air as though he was picking a fly. 4 for 97.
2 men out for the hook shot for Graham Wood, which is standard procedure these days.
And that's got to be close. Yes, Graham Wood is on his way. That ball certainly wasn't bouncing very high. It was just a matter of whether it pitched in line. And Stephen Randell was quite happy that it pitched in line. So Graham Wood on his way, LBW to Garner.
Joel Garner, who's had his problems, strikes first blood. And the big question is here whether it pitches in line with leg stump. And just about Graham Wood playing forward, only a foot or so. And by Steve Randell having a good look at it and then putting the finger up. So Graham Wood out, LBW, bowled Garner, and Australia 1 for 38.
It's off the glove, I think. Beautifully taken by Geoffrey Dujon. And umpire Steve Randall signifies that, yes, it did come off the glove. And that was a quicker delivery from Joel Garner. And it got a little bounce. But a magnificent catch from Geoffrey Dujon.
Certainly was quicker. Unexpected lift, hip high. Brushed the glove, and the acrobatic Dujon there as ever. Injured in the first innings with an injured knee, coming back into the game with a bang, taking a marvellous catch to dismiss Wood. 1 for 17.
Fieldage 12. Vessels facing, not yet off the mark. Oh, and he's gone. Old Garner has knocked the off stump right out of the ground. He did the same thing up in Brisbane, but on that occasion, Kepler Vessels wasn't playing a shot. On this occasion, he was beaten by a beautiful off cutter.
That was a superb ball. I'm just wondering whether Vessels got an edge to that. Got very close to it, but didn't lay a bat on it. And that really was a terrific delivery. It must have pitched about middle or slightly towards middle and leg. That was Vessels' third ball. And Daddles, unfortunately, accompanies him back with the ball. Out without scoring, bowled Garner. And Australia now in trouble at 2 for 17.
Well, Kim Hughes has made one change before he even gets to the crease. He's got the Australian cap on rather than the helmet that he normally bats in. And I would imagine that he'll be hoping that that changes his luck with the bat. Garner really charging in, and it's out. First ball, he's got him LBW. And Joel Garner is now on a hat-trick. He's picked up 3 wickets in 5 balls, and the Australian innings is in tatters.
And what a disaster for Kim Hughes. Naught in the first innings, naught in the second. He's bagged a pair, and that's a most unpleasant sensation. That ball pitching slightly outside off stump, cutting back into about the line of the leg stump. Hughes open, playing across the line. Garner's on a hat-trick. He's got 3 for none in 5 balls, and Australia now really struggling desperately against this Garner, who's really tearing in and bowling with exceptional pace, good direction, and moving the ball considerably. 3 for 17.
Number of misfields, snatching at the ball.
On, off stump goes right out of the ground. So David Boone is out 1 short of his 50. Comprehensively bowled by the Big Bird.
Well, he was giving himself room, had been for most of the morning, looking to run that ball down the third man and the off stump out of the ground, not in behind it, just trying to run it down the third man, the typical one day shot. Out goes the off stump. So 7 for 450.
And that one stopped a little bit, and that'll be played just that little bit early. Joel Garner has picked up the second wicket for Parry Bowl Garner, and Dirk Randall is out for 49. Quite a simple catch that. Garner should have been bowling the whole yard. Right up to the bat, both on goals, and that's 5 for 195.
Well, it's up and it's straight, and Botham's trying to smash it over the top of the boundary, through the gate it goes, and up goes one of those stumps.
And he's a field against for a caught behind. He's out caught behind. Cut shot ball. Murray went down, took the catch, came for it. Botham remained there, and eventually the umpire gave him up. There it is.
The batsman is concerned as to whether it carried. And it probably just got there. Good catch by Derek Murray.
Oh, he's had a bit of a go. A bit of pressure applied by Joel Garner. He's out. That's a shame, really, from this one's point of view, because he's playing very well. Danny Roberts takes the catch. First wicket is falling at 53.
And what a good start for Pakistan. And a disappointing end for Rizwan, just not concentrating for a moment, hitting across the line of this ball, which might have just held its own. He was aiming for a hit over long on. In fact, he skied the ball, sliced it up into the mid-off position, and Andy Roberts coming around there made no mistake about the catch. Eyes on the ball all the time, as you can see, hands cupped. And in it goes. It's not going to get out of bounds. So the first wicket has fallen, 53 runs on the board.
Raja is out. Pakistan in further trouble now. 4-4-34 with Raja bowled by Garner for one.
Real good delivery that. Pitched well up. No problem there with the pitch. Just with the eyesight and footwork. And Pakistan now 4-34. To Mohsin Khan.
And that's out. Yes, finally, breakthrough. Joel Garner getting the edge and Clive Roy taking a safe catch at first hit.
Being in form and out of form. Mohsin out of form, flashing at this ball outside the off stump, getting a thin edge, and it goes at comfortable catching height to Clive Lloyd at first slip. So Mohsin is out, caught at first slip, with his total at 6. 1 wicket down now for 29.
Joel Garner bowling to Ijaz.
That's in the air, easy catch here again for Haynes. And that's Ijaz gone, caught by Haynes, off Garner. Terrible shot by Ijaz. And another comfortable catch for Haynes.
A bit of extra bounce here, but Ijaz was palpably late on the stroke there. And it was the wrong stroke anyway. And Joel Garner deserved that. Had two chances missed in the one over a little while ago. And has bowled very well. 6-4-1-5-1.
And that's a similar shot and a similar dismissal. So Sarfraz is out, first ball he faced, Roberts taking the catch. And now 7-151. So first ball dismissal. Don't know what Sarfraz is trying to do here, just trying to work it away on the onside. A little bit of extra bounce once more and Roberts holding the catch.
A little duck makes its appearance. Very welcome as far as Sarfraz is concerned. And that's a really good piece of bowling as well. Three good Yorkers to Jeff Lawson.
So Lawson is out for a duck. Very, very good bowling.
Joel Garner to Thompson. Very close to the shot of the day. Javed Miandad now faces Joel Garner.
And that's gone. Caught behind. Beautiful delivery from the big bird. Javed out. Caught Dujon. Bowled Garner. 26. 4-75.
There's really not a lot Javed could do about that delivery. Had to play it. That was a beautiful leg cutter. Just going far enough. Jeffrey Dujon going up there with the bounce. The umpire Mel Johnson really didn't even need to signify that. Javed was on his way, and Pakistan are 4-75.
Saleh Malik will be captain of the Pakistan under-19 team, which will tour Australia towards the end of this month. He will leave the senior team to take up that assignment, but very, very highly considered in Pakistan.
I wonder if they'll let him go if he gets a quick 100 in this game, Tony.
Well, he didn't get quite 100 here. Bowled second ball off the inside edge. And real disappointment for the young man.
Yes, it is a pity. I was really looking forward to having a look at the youngster. But an inside edge onto the stumps. He's ended his first innings in Australia. Accompanied by... Battles the duck back to the pavilion. So Salim Malik out for a duck.
Joel Garner to Ijaz.
he's gone. That's an extraordinary stroke, in fact, to play against Garner, first ball of his new spell. Each has the batsman out.
Was developing into a nice little partnership of 22, but Ejaz just losing concentration. A change in bowling lineup bringing instant success for the West Indies. So Joel Garner now 3 for 12.
Garner to Imran. What is it? That he's gone. Yes, Imran walking a half-hearted shot there, and that time Dujon making the catch. That was a very, very faint outside edge. Imran Khan didn't even wait for the umpire's decision. So that's a bit of a blow to Pakistan.
Well bowled by Joel Garner, just concentrating short of a length and straight through to Dujon. He hasn't kept cleanly today, but he made no mistake with that one. Imran Khan finds himself on the way back to the pavilion, out for 31. And Pakistan now 5 for 150.
Well caught, nicely judged by Gordon Greenidge, limping a little, but made it in perfect safety.
Good catch, fell, but under that, and Greenidge still limping slightly, kept his eye on the ball and judged perfection. 175 for 8.
And Dyson ran straight into him. He's bowling! What a beautiful delivery from Garner. Well, that'll teach him to run into him. He produced a magnificent Yorker, which bowled John Dyson neck and crop.
Well, you don't upset Big Joel and get away with it, and what a ball. Dyson in pretty good form, just hitting the pad and then going back onto the off stump. The intended Yorker, and that's a vital blow to Australia. Dyson out for 37.
Overs are being bowled, so very tough for them.
Chappell bowled by Joel Garner, having a wild swing. He realizes that if this is going to be a match, if they're going to be 15 overs before the rain comes, that Australia are still too far behind. It is worth the swing.
I just wonder, Tony, whether the 2 minutes and the changeover may be advantage to Australia here. Instead of getting through the overs, with Greg Chappell getting out and the extra time that'll be used off must just give Australia a chance of perhaps getting out of this game. Anyhow, now Australia are 3 for 43.
Well, we're back here at the MCG with that sky ominously hanging over the ground. This is the 13th over of the innings. The West Indies will be hurrying to get through their 15, which will constitute a match. Australia, on the other hand, very far behind on the required run rate. They've lost 3 wickets, and they'll be interested to take up as much time as possible. The truck there waiting to go onto the ground as soon as the rain comes. We understand that the wind is howling down at Brighton, which is not far away. Hughes, the batsman. And the Yorker wraps him on his toes. Give him out, leg before wicket. Long consideration, Hughes out, leg before wicket, first ball to Garner. And the long walk back and the long walk in by the new batsman may take up just sufficient time.
And it hurt Kim Hughes in more ways than one. The fact that he lost his wicket and also very much an injured foot. So first ball for Kim Hughes, and Joel Garner finds himself on a hat-trick.
And he's gone, leg before. Chappell shuffling across. Big Bird Garner was in no doubt, and neither was umpire Mel Johnson.
And that didn't get up at all. There have been others that have lifted sharply. There's no doubt he's absolutely plumb. But I think he had every right to expect that to lift a bit more than that. So, Australia now 4 for 43.
Well, a number of people will be surprised to find Greg Chappell so high up in the tyre power strike rate. 77.52 runs per 100 balls faced. But he has had a few innings this year in which he really has gone after the bowling, notably a 61 against the West Indies in Brisbane.
Garner to Chappell.
And he's bowled him.
Greg Chappell gone cheaply once more, and yet another duck against his name.
Well, Chappell absolutely amazed there by the way that ball nipped back. He was, in fact, I think, a little late on that stroke. Garner absolutely elated there at yet another duck to Greg Chappell. And Greg Chappell there shaking his head very ruefully as he goes to the pavilion. No score against his name. And 2 wickets have fallen for Trent.
Garner to Laird.
Will be close. Yes, he's got him. Joel Garner strikes. The first wicket falls at 37.
Joel Garner, first blood for the West Indies. Ball that Bruce Laird played back to. There was a lot of movement off the seam. Let's have a look. And a little high, perhaps, but Bruce Laird playing from the crease. Umpire Bruce Martin gave it a lot of consideration, and Big Joel agreeing with him. Bruce Laird finds himself on the way back to the pavilion. Reasonable start, out for 13. Australia 1 for 37. Garner to Hooks.
It's in the air and it's
out. It's gone. Caught at mid-off. Well, that really has to be the end of Australia. Hooks there trying to hit the ball over the top of mid-off, not timing it very well, and hitting it straight to Gordon Greenidge.
Joel Garner striking again for the West Indian side. It's had a superb summer. Disappointed David Hooks. He's around the wicket. It's a short of a length, and he tries to drive on the up. In the safe hands of Gordon Greenidge at mid-off.
And your commentators, Tony Gregg and Bill Lurie.
Down the leg side, and oh, what a catch! No ball called. Well, that was a magnificent catch by Jeffrey Dujon, but it makes no difference. Garner once again has gone over the front line, and so Vessel survives.
Dujon doing a magnificent job. He's across for the left-hander. He takes one, two paces and throws himself full length and gathers in a superb catch, the catch that wasn't, of Clayton's. And Vessel survives, a no ball from Joel Garner.
Joel Garner bowling to Kepler Vessels.
Well bowled, and that ball's bowled him. He's bowled him. So once again, Kepler Vessels getting tucked up. And as a result of trying to play around that front pad, getting a little inside edge, I think, from the ball bobbing onto the leg stump.
And a beautiful piece of bowling. This was pointed out, he's attacking leg stump. The angle was nearly off stump. He tried to force it square. Got a bottom edge. It bounced once, twice onto the leg bail. And a good piece of work by Joel Garner. The West Indians have done their homework on Kepler Vessels, and he departs for 7 runs. Australia 1 for 12.
16 to Mosen. There's a confident appeal, and umpire Mel Johnson agrees. And Mosen Khan is on his way, LBW, to Joel Garner.
In the previous over, we're just commenting on how Mosen tends to play back just so often. And a very good delivery from Joel Garner sends Mosen Khan on his way back to the pavilion when he was just looking to be in threatening form. So Mosen out for 16, LBW bowled back.
Change in batting order. Just 4 overs to go. And a tremendous yorker there from Joel Garner, slamming it right underneath Salim's bat. Salim looking at his bat ruefully, almost as though he wished it was a couple of inches longer.
What a magnificent delivery that was from Big Joel Garner. At the stumps, perfectly pitch, quicker delivery, getting underneath the bat of Salim, and that's the place to bowl when you come into these final overs. Magnificent piece of bowling by Big Joel Garner. Coming back after injury, he certainly appears to be in great form. Nelly hitting the stump there on the full. Beautiful yorker. So the end of Salim, and Pakistan 6 for 163.
I would imagine Joel Garner has made his point with the West Indies selectors. I find it very hard to leave him out of the final series now. Oh, and he's done it again. Straight under the bat of Ejaz. And the big man has probably the best Yorker in cricket, I would say.
Big Joel now running through these down the order Pakistan batsmen, and what another great delivery. Just a couple of inches underneath the bat, got through the probing bat of Ejaz, and Joel Garner picking up his second wicket with the Yorker. Great piece of bowling once again from Big Joel Garner. Ejaz out without a duck, with a duck rather. And Pakistan now 7 for 164.
And an edge, and well taken there by Geoffrey Dujon. Marvellous catch, moving away to his right. And that ball wasn't far off the ground when he took it. Tremendous effort from the West Indies keeper.
There's Dujon having to move away to his right there to make that catch. Ritchie went driving at the ball just outside off stump. And it stayed down as well. And Dujon catching it just above the surface. So another wicket to a wicket to Joel Garner. Ritchie out for four. And Australia now 4 for 169. Lee Marsh has been model of consistency so far. World Series Cup hasn't been dismissed under double figures in any innings. Already five runs from five balls.
It's in the air. Dujon's a man calling for it. He's got the cap off. He's taking his time. He's got it. And Border is out. And that's a vital breakthrough. Border out of form, trying to hit down the ground. And look at the West Indians. They're delighted.
Well, we saw a mishap occur over in Perth last weekend when Kim Hughes going for a big hit. Played a similar shot to that, the ball ballooning up into the air and Geoffrey Dujon missing the catch. But on this occasion, that was not to be the case. Border up and under, and Geoffrey Dujon, good judgment by him. He called it early, flipped off the cap and into the safe gloves of Geoffrey Dujon. An elated keeper too. No doubt that wicket of last Sunday would have still been in his mind. So a vital wicket, great breakthrough for the West Indies, and now Australia struggling a little, 5 for 176.
Garner comes in now to bowl to Border.
Beautifully bowled, that's close, a big shout from behind the wicket, but not out, says the umpire, Peter O'Connell. Dujon cannot believe it.
Just for a moment, I thought it clipped his gloves on the way through. A very good delivery from Joel Garner. Looked as though it did clip the gloves on the way through. Alan Border, quick to look around. By Peter McConnell down at the outer end, ruling in favour of the batsman.
Beautifully bowled, he's got him, cut back and Border bowled again. A good delivery from Joel Garner, the breeze coming across the ground, cut back in an inside edge and Border bowled again.
And a great over by Joel Garner. Had Alan Border in all sorts of trouble early on in the over, and then producing this magnificent delivery, threw him for pace. And deflection down under the stumps from Alan Border. So good breakthrough by the West Indies, and Alan Border's run of outs still continues. So Australia now 1 for 14.
Joel Garner to David Boone.
Oh, it's up in the air, could be out, slips under it, he's caught it. Boone standing his ground. Off his arm, maybe. Well, that's a surprise. I thought that was off the glove. It's all happening here at the Melbourne Cricket Ground.
Magnificent first up delivery by Joel Garner, and taken on the shoulder by David Boone. Certainly did look as though the gloves were in the road, Bill, but he just dropped them out the road. And Richard Gabriel getting back.
Bowled in. Beautiful Yorker by Joel Garner. Strikes again, and Bessel's bowled clean as a whistle. Garner with that high action speared it in towards the stumps and knocked him over. Beauty.
We've seen Garner York the tail enders on numerous occasions this summer. On that occasion it was the bat of Kepa Vessels that he snuck underneath of, and that was a beautiful delivery by Garner, removing that off stump of Kepler Vessels. Vessels out for 17, Australia in the 10th over 25 for the loss of two wickets.
Wayne Phillips now taking strike to Garner.
It's in the air. Holding's coming in for a minute, he's dropped the last three, but he catches this one, and Phillips is out.
And holding did the rest. So,
Wayne Phillips out for 22 off 38 deliveries.
6 for 210. Just one over to go now. It's going to be bowled by Joel Garner. He'll be trying to produce those nasty Yorkers that he bowls so well. He's bowling to Rodney Marsh. It's gone miles in the sky. Dujon's running away after it. He'll get there. He'll catch it. Got caught there by Dujon. Marsh trying to smash that over the offside field. Top edge. The ball went miles in the sky.
As you can see that Geoffrey Dujon has learned from that mistake over in Perth last weekend where he dropped Kim Hughes. This was his catch all the way. The ball going back over his head. He called whether it was his and charged after it. And a well-judged catch taken with the glove. So the end of a good innings from Rodney Marsh. His last appearance for Australia in the international arena. And once again, turning in a good...
He's bowled him. Well, that was the last ball of the innings. The Australians 8 for 212. That's the end of the 50 overs.
Joel Garner is coming into bowl, and the batsman is Graham Wood.
In the air and out. First ball. Graham Wood coming right off the shoulder of the bat. There was quite a bit of bounce in this wicket for the McDonald's Cup semi-final. That was the New South Wales-Victoria match. And it looks as though there's still quite a bit of bounce in this wicket. And Graham Wood has fallen victim to that extra bounce.
And what a dream start for the West Indies. Joel Garner with that height of his, you can see that bounce. It's up around about hip high. Graham Wood was pretty keen to try and get onto the front foot. And a nice simple catch into the gully. A bad start for the Australians. Graham Wood picking up a duck. Our first delivery. Caught holding, bowl Garner without scoring off the very first ball.
And that could be another one. It's going into the deep. Greenidge is there. Takes it well. Well, he dropped one earlier on most other grounds in Australia. That would have been six at the MCG. Wayne Phillips caught Gordon Greenidge, bowled Joel Garner for a quick fire 23.
Yes, he had to go for it, and the face of the bat opening there a little bit, and that resulted in the ball going a little bit too high. Greenidge taking a beautiful catch there, moving a long way around to his right, and at the end making a very good catch. That was a very useful innings by Phillips. Out now off the bowling of Garner for 23, a quick fire 23 at that. Australia 5 for 220. Garner to Silva.
Well, and that's a tremendous delivery, well taken by Geoffrey Dujon, and that ball coming off the glove, and Amal Silva didn't even hang around to wait for the umpire. He was on his way. A brute of a delivery.
Certainly seemed unfair, that delivery. He's very close to the stumps. He's bowling at middle and leg, it cut, got a glove or the handle, and Dujon took a fine catch, fine piece of bowling, and Amal Silva out for four, but no discredit to him. Great piece of bowling from Joel Garner.
Garner to Wetamuni. Must be out. Vivian Richards. Straightforward catch. Wetamuni goes, and Joel Garner is posing awful problems out there this morning on a very lively surface.
Not only is Garner getting movement off the wicket, such as this, away from the bat, he's also getting lift, and Wetamuni there just exasperated, going for the off drive, was never on, found the edge of the bat, and that went very quickly, about chest height to Viv Richards. So, Siddharth Wetamuni out, caught Richard Bell Garner, 8, and the second wicket is down.
Here is Wetamuni now.
Gone! Yes, he's gone, slashing it a wide delivery, trying to push it along. Siddharth Wetamuni caught behind for 2.
A bit of frustration showing there. That ball well wide, good thick edge, and ball just sticking in Geoffrey Dujon's gloves. Went straight to him. He didn't time it properly, but it really was a straightforward catch. And Wetamuni comes in now, and Sri Lanka having a very bad start. 1 for 4.
In the air and well taken. Gordon Greenidge is the man in the gully. He's hurt himself. He's taken the catch, and once again having problems with the leg. It looks to be around about the knee on this occasion. Or is it perhaps the groin area that they're going for?
Eventful piece of cricket in more ways than one. Wayne Phillips, a quicker delivery from Joel Garner, catching him, squaring him up, and Greenidge diving forward, perhaps just twisting that knee of his. He has had a few problems for it, but an early setback for the Australians. Phillips out for four and bowled by Garner.
Jones has come in and has put back to bowlers look good. Well, not good any longer. Off the inside edge, down into his stumps. And that's 3 for 19 as Jones is bowled by Garner for 11. Chopping it back onto his stumps.
Yes, Jones looking good before that, but not good enough as Garner makes that ball come back from outside the off stump. Jones trying to manoeuvre into position to give himself room to square cut. Trying to dictate turns to Joel Garner. Garner doesn't permit it. Onto the wicket it goes, 3 for 19.
Graham with enormous pressure on the opening batsman against Joel Garner.
Off the edge, in the air, Vivian Richards under it, and the first Australian wicket has fallen, and Joel Garner's burst over.
What a beautiful piece of bowling. It was well caught, but that was a lethal delivery. Very few batsmen in the world could have handled that. There is right arm over the wicket, he digs it in short, come at Graham Wood, tried to keep it down, got the top of the bat, and Richards took a simple but well-judged catch, and a great start for the West Indian team. What a great one-day bowler Joel Garner is. Out for a duck, disappointing for Graham Wood, but the elated West Indians gather as one, and Australia 1 for 3.
Well, that's a good delivery. Richie Richardson grabs it, and Smith doesn't even wait for the umpire's decision. He walks. And what a nasty delivery. I think that was even worse than the one that Graham Wood caught.
Joel Garner is flat out. I don't think he could bowl any faster. And this wicket, unfortunately, he's got a lot of bounce in it. That was a lethal delivery. We see him just a little bit wide of the stumps and dug it in it, come at him. And Richardson took a pretty simple catch, but not much you can do with a delivery like that. And that's a great piece of bowling, and Australia are already in trouble in the third over at 2 for 7.
Holding. Joel Garner. Sudden all round again. And LBW. Simon O'Donnell gone. Tony Crafter gives him. We may find that O'Donnell was trying to take the ball off his stumps there from Joel Garner, whipping it away just in these last few overs. That hit on the roll of the pad. He was up off the ground a little, but it was certainly in front. Garner and, Dujon came up with the appeal a little later. So it's all going on out there. Everyone's getting a bit fratchy out in the centre, but not in the commentary box here. Tony Cozier is hanging loose and cool.
O'Donnell on 69 off just 79 balls, and no one can argue with that. It's pretty good going. Oh, well caught. Well, hasn't he caught some catches in this match? Joel Garner almost looks as if he can't believe it. He caught a great catch to dismiss Border, and that one was hit back at him very firmly. The end of a tremendous innings, this by Simon O'Donnell, and good to see the youngster making his mark.
Joel Garner, I don't think he had time to even think that he had caught that. Hit with tremendous power by Simon O'Donnell, looking for the drive straight down the ground, full toss, and Garner didn't have full control over it at the start, and then the ball holding onto it in those hands of his, picking up his first wicket. But the end of a very good innings from Simon O'Donnell. Australia 7 for 89 at one stage, now for 9 for 176, and O'Donnell out for 69.
That's out. Well, I would say from the reaction of the bowler and keeper that there might have been a little inside edge on that, and also from the reaction of the batsman.
Yes, it was one of those stifled appeals. I think even Richie hesitated there. We see him go back and On replay, you don't actually see the edge, but certainly Howarth indicated Joel Garner went on with the appeal. Just a little bit of an inside edge onto the pad. Very difficult for umpires. Howarth, who's a walker, he walked previously here when caught behind, and today he had no intentions of looking at the umpire. New Zealand, 2 for 24.
Now it's going to be Joel Garner. It's in the air and he's gone. Caught by Richardson at second slip. What is a lovely delivery. Slightly further pitched up. Thick outside edge. And that went straight through. Nice catching height too to Richardson. But he made no mistake. It looks as if he may have hurt his finger. But have a look at this.
Well, forward a little bit late. Having been forced on the back foot earlier. Athey, who is so much a front foot player and who was coming forward against the Australian pace attack in their opening match with full confidence, came forward quite tentatively there and got the outside edge. 2 for 10.
Joel Garner to continue.
Edged and taken, very simply taken by Jeffrey Dujon. So when Joel gets his feet in the right position, he's got a pretty good strike rate.
David Gower, very prone to flashing outside the off stump in the one-day game. Generally, there's no slips around. That one, a very fine edge, straight two to the keeper, Dujon. Simplest of catch, the big bird's now taken two. Had problems with his feet, but certainly when the delivery is live, looks pretty dangerous. Gower for 11, England 3 for 35.
Beautiful catch. No, he says not. He's appealing. Now, what's happened there? Joel Garner reckon he caught it. Tossed it in the air. Square leg says yes. What's happening now? Well, Joel Garner thought he had it. And, in fact, Graham Dilley is walking away. A bit of confusion there. It was so low. Joel Garner's right hand perhaps so big that no one was quite certain what had happened. Garner was certain that he had taken the catch.
I was quite wrong when I said that the big bird's not as flexible as he used to be. He got down extremely well, got a big mitt underneath that one. Umpire Peter McConnell looked across to square leg. Umpire Dick French was there and he was nodding furiously, saying that yes, the big fella had got the hand underneath it. So Dilley is out, caught and bowl Joel Garner. And that's 5 in an innings to Joel Garner. That's the third time he's done it in international one-dayers. And England have lost the 9th wicket now with a score at 211. Joel Garner, fast bowler from Barbados. Gladstone Small, a man who was born in Barbados, now qualified to play for England, comes in at number 11.
Joel Garner is coming in to bowl to Geoffrey Marsh. Your commentators are Ian Chappell, and alongside him is Tony Cosey.
That's it, first wicket gone. Garner gets Marsh. Touch to catch to the keeper. And Joel Garner has struck with his second delivery, and Australia are off to a bad start.
As expected, the West Indies opening bowlers pushing Marsh onto the back foot. And he gets a very faint edge straight through to Jeffrey Dujon. A simple catch. And Australia are 1 for 2.
Oh, big appeal there for LBW. He's got him. He's out, LBW. Well, that one didn't bounce very much. It was a quicker ball from Joel Garner. And what a breakthrough this is for the West Indies. Just when Australia didn't need a wicket to fall, Joel Garner has struck. So Dean Jones, who's played pretty well, he's out, LBW to Garner for 40.
Dean Jones realises the predicament that his country's in now. There's no doubt about that. Absolutely. Would have missed off and leg, taken middle right out of the ground, halfway up, and the big bird goes for the sky. Give us a slap of the hand. Dean Jones, a very fine 40 runs, scored in 79 deliveries. And Australia now 2 wickets down for 85 in the 27th over.
straight into the mid-on's hands, and that's it. Hard but straight and low to the fielder, Haynes. And Greg Ritchie has gone as Joel Garner comes back. The first over of a new spell. And Ritchie trying to go over the top, not quite making it.
Yes, not the shot that was needed at this stage. He was playing too well for that type of shot. Straight to Desmond Haynes. So Ritchie's out for 35. It's 4 for 1, 2, 2.
That's pretty close, yes. Robin Bailash didn't have to look for too long there. The big bird forced Bill Athey back and trapped him with the off-cutter.
Yes, half that wicket should go to Malcolm Marshall. He's certainly forced Bill Athey back. And then on comes big Joel Garner, who's not slow to fine bowlers. Bowling on a wicket that's got a bit of pace in it today. And they remove the opener, Bill Athey. Very happy West Indian team, and rightly so, because Athey and Chris Broad have done the job. It's 1 for 11.